right on time as usual. What didn't you bring? Oh, George. Hello. Have a seat in the waiting room. I'll call you when the doctor's ready.
George learned that the thing you need most in a doctor's waiting room is patience.
Huh?
A mysterious sound. George listened as quietly as he could.
Dr. Baker, we'll see you now.
Oh, great. Come on, George. We're finally getting out of the waiting room.
George gave up hope of hearing any mystery sound past that sneezing.
I'm still waiting for Dr. Gesund.
Well, I'm sure he'll be right with you. Excuse me, has Dr. Gesund seen you yet?
No. Where is he?
He should be right with you. You're waiting for Dr. Gesund, too? He should be right with you.
Oh, hi, Doctor. You remember George?
How could I forget? Before your last checkup, I never knew the X-ray machine fit out the window.
Huh?
Dr. Baker, have you seen Dr. Gesund? His patients are waiting.
No. You should check the X-ray room. And you should take off your shirt for the examination.
Yeah, sure, Doc.
George thought he'd like to be a doctor, because Dr. Baker seemed so smart. And he got to wear a really great white coat.
Okay, let's get started. Up on the scale. Whoa, I think you need to cut out the desserts. You've gained some weight.
What? I have maybe one donut a month. I run marathons. It's impossible.
Ah, same as last year.
Whew.
This is how I check his reflexes, George.
My knee's starting to get sore.
Oh, sorry. I never get to play with a monkey.
Dr. Gesund.
Okay, take a long, deep breath.
Oh,
I don't like the sound of that breathing.
No, George was...
Whoa. Ever use the stethoscope, George? I use it to hear things that I can't see.
That's the sound of my heart.
You can play with your heart while we go to the X-ray room.
Not everything had a heartbeat. But George found sounds he hadn't noticed with his bare ears. A doctor coat just didn't sound the same without a doctor in it. This part of the couch made a different sound. The that wasn't the couch. It sounded big. It sounded heavy. And it came from up there.
Huh?
You must have heard our new neighbor walking around. He moved in last week.
Huh?
What George had heard seemed heavier than footsteps.
What are you doing? George, you must have heard our neighbor walking. That's all it could be. It's not like he's got some wild animal up there.
The man with the yellow hat lived with George. So why couldn't the new neighbor live with an animal? But what kind? Of course, the new neighbor had brought home an elephant. The man with the yellow hat had to hear this.
George? You dreamt about an elephant? Oh, no more nature books before you go to sleep, George. They're obviously giving you strange dreams. This is better bedtime reading. The Happy Sleepy Monkey.
Good night.
This new sound certainly wasn't an elephant walking around. It was an elephant that was doing what?
Didn't sleep at all last night.
George never realized there were so many sounds in the world. He'd never listened hard enough. To the apartment upstairs, where the new neighbor lived with his elephant.
George, what are you doing? George, don't spy on our new neighbor, please. How about when I get home, we go up and introduce...
A perfect time for a trip.
Ooh, ooh.
Bottles and newspapers went to the basement. But some things had to be taken to the recycling center.
Hey, looks like you could use a hand. Or maybe another foot. I'm guessing you're going the same way I am. I have to pick up a package for Betsy. The recycling center's right next door. Stick it all in Betsy's wagon. I'll give you a lift. It's gonna be easier pushing you downhill. George, are you okay? The wheel! I'll get it! Boy, rolled a long way. I bet you could get it to roll from here to the other end of the park if you wanted. Might even set some sort of wheel rolling record. Say, what do you think? For the record? It's really going. It's gone. Hurry, after it. You go that way. I got it. Could it be? Oh my gosh! The package place will be closing soon. Come on, we'll find the wheel later. Kick! This isn't so bad, as long as we keep the weight. Kick! Over the back wheels, and you keep kicking the other wheel back in, we'll be there in... Hey, we're here! With time to spare! Our problems are over! Oh, this is gonna be a problem. Good idea, George. Let's take your stuff to the recycling center. Then we'll have room in the wagon. Hey, what are you doing, George? That won't work. Cuz, it's from a baby carriage. It's for babies. I got something better.
Springtime seemed like a bad excuse to get rid of something fun. So why not make a new Springmobile? What's more spring-like than fresh fruit? George thought his mobile had everything a mobile needs. Had he forgotten something?
Balance. That's what you need. Like this.
Great.
That was something.
For our next demonstration of perfect balance, we need a volunteer from the audience.
Huh?
Save it for the show, Claire. She means we can fix that.
Ta-da!
Ooh.
George wondered, who were these incredible fruit balancers?
Zucchinis!
Piscotti!
Giorgio, these are my friends, the famous zucchinis.
We came by to order food for our rehearsal. Our show is tonight.
Molto bene. I'm gonna deliver it myself.
Thanks! Ciao!
When he woke up that morning, George had never heard of them. But now, all he wanted was to be an amazing balancing zucchini. Being a cat, Gnocchi didn't see what was so tough about balancing. But George needed to see how the zucchinis did it.
You want to deliver this to the zucchinis for me? Maybe you like to see them again because you want to be a zucchini, eh? Oh, I know. Because, Giorgio, I too dream that I could be an amazing zucchini. Follow your dream, Giorgio. But hurry up before the pizza gets cold.
Steve, come on. Work with me here.
Aw, give it up, Betsy. You're too small to move a big brother like me.
Hi, George.
Hey, what do you got there? Smells good. Hey, what happened?
You moved closer, and now it's like we weigh the same. Thanks, George.
That which gives us the strength to perform our amazing feats!
I think he wants to join us.
It's not that easy. It takes lots of practice to do things like us. Balance requires total control. I never sneeze unless a cat.
Leo's allergic to cat hair, and sneezing is very bad for his balance. It would wreck our show.
Gnocchi was determined to go back in there and watch what was going on. On a windy day, the country house windows were almost musical. As good as the wind sounded, it felt even better. Smelled good, too. There had to be lots of things a clever monkey could fly out his window, like heavy winter socks. Birds he drew. His lucky brick. And there was even better stuff downstairs.
What's the excitement, George? Yeah, it's a great day to play in the wind. I'll get the door for you. George, if you're wondering how a big yellow hat would fly, you know the rule, buddy. No one is allowed to play with the yellow hat. Have fun. Clean up after yourself, and don't blow away.
George couldn't decide what he'd fly first. And then he didn't have to. Jumpy Squirrel tries hard to spend all his time in trees, leaping about. But when it's time to eat, he has to go where the nuts are buried.
Weather, huh? Careful, I'll lose control. Flying a kite's all about control. Oh, this is a lazy Susan.
He didn't know what a kite was when he woke up that morning. But there was nothing in the world George wanted more than to fly a kite.
Sorry, I can't turn over control to an inexperienced city kid. This isn't as easy as I make it look. I studied the Beaufort wind scale for 3 years. I never make mistakes. Oh! Rats! That's never coming down. For a city kid, you sure can't climb a tree. Not a scratch. Thanks, George. As a reward, I'll let you fly her.
Bill! Billy!
Coming! I promised I'd help Mom gut a pumpkin. I won't be long. You watch the kite till I get back.
George figured he could watch the kite even better while it flew.
Hey, George, lose your kite?
Hey, that's your best bird yet. Oh, the tag? Yeah, that means it's a homing pigeon.
Oh. Huh?
Well, they're special birds that always return home. Hold on. Just because he came back here doesn't make this his home. Homing pigeons have special homes. Ah, that's the pizza. Wash up. Did I leave that open? We don't want that pigeon getting in here. Did you wash those hands? Wash them good. Yesterday you passed me the butter and it had grass on it. George? Oh, you want privacy. Now, where is that pizza cutter? Whoa! I was afraid he'd sneak in. Okay, you open the door, I'll catch him. George, he needs to go home. This just isn't a good home for pigeons.
If that's how it had to be, then George would turn their home into a good home for pigeons. This called for research. Pigeon made his choice. Now, there was only one logical way for George to get a tree up here. He'd have to build one. The pipe cleaner tree looked nice. A tree needs to be bigger. With clay, George could make a tree as big and thick as he wanted. Too much water. This called for research. Now that George knew everything about trees, he searched for the most tree-like stuff he could find. You don't know impatient until you've been a monkey waiting for a donut.
How about eggs with those donuts? Hey, count the eggs and write down how many we have.
Ready. So how many eggs do we have? There are no eggs. Well, why didn't you write zero? Oh, you don't know. I thought I was teaching you everything, and I forgot nothing. George, no time like the present to learn. You see, zero alone means no eggs. None at all. But zero with other numbers makes them mean a lot more. See, if we write a zero after one, that's 10. Write another zero, that's 100. That's 1,000. 10,000. Hey, nice zeros, you've got it. Whoa!
Morning.
I'll go in here and buy eggs while you get the donuts, okay? One dozen donuts, please. We'll meet back home. And be a good little monkey.
Someone on a donut mission can't stop and play. Dogs don't understand. George was really hungry, but his order only had a measly one on it.
Huh?
Then he remembered what the man with the yellow hat had told him about zeros.
George, Chalky, good to see ya. Oh, is that an order for your friend with the yellow hat? 100 dozen? Oh, our biggest order ever! Oh, he must be having a giant donut party.
George realized what his zeros had done. But try explaining that to a dog.
Okay, now, where did I leave that piece of paper? I misread the order. It's 1,000 dozen. Oh, this is the biggest day in the entire history of donuts. We'll have to have more donuts flown in from other towns. Oh. Let's see. There's 5 dozen, 10 dozen, 15 dozen. My mistake. It's 100.
This was still more donuts than one little monkey could ever eat. But George came up with a great idea. He'd just give them away. Who doesn't want a donut? The train station lady wanted donuts. But it didn't work out.
Papers, here ya are! Free donut with every paper!
Before long, those two stacks of boxes were gone.
Yes, sir?
Well, that is pretty impressive, isn't it, George?
Oh, thanks. But it's nothing compared to Mr. Quint's model whaling boat. That's it over there.
Draw the nets, laddies. Aye, aye, Cap'n.
And over there is Mrs. Rinkin's ark. And look at all those over there. It's some pretty tough competition this year.
Now, don't underestimate yourself, Bill. That is one fine-looking boat. Good luck. Oh, sure, you can stay with Bill. I'll set you up right here. Okay, I'll be over at the bleachers saving up some seats and sizing up Bill's competition.
I'd sure like to win a ribbon, George. To buy this kit, I had to save 9 weeks of money for my paper route. Oh, I almost forgot to do my paper route. Could you do me a big favor and watch my boat while I'm gone? See you soon.
George knew boat watching was serious business. There were a lot of nice boats here, but not one person had built the greatest boat. A ferry boat. Maybe he could build one. Commanding a ferry had been George's lifelong dream. Ever since he first heard of them. Earlier that morning. Luckily, Bill's boat looked good as new. Maybe he just put it down the wrong way.
Hey, George, how's it going? I'll be back after I deliver the rest of these papers. Thanks for taking good care of my boat.
George couldn't figure out what he'd done to it. It looked perfect. But he knew one thing.
No!
Bill couldn't enter the contest with this boat. George had to build him a new one, and fast. Unfortunately, George had no idea how to do that. First, George had to find out what boats were made of. If you've got to build a boat in a hurry, a bucket of toys is a handy thing to have. Jumpy Squirrel's new favorite thing to do was watch George sink boats. And he wasn't disappointed. It turned out metal didn't float so well, especially when it was full of holes. Plastic might work. Just like the other toy boat. But metal cars are heavy. Even so, it was sort of floating. It was just sort of floating underwater.